So we write the program as a truly parallel program. Or in other words, the application programmer is going to think about his application and write the program as an explicitly parallel program. And there are two styles of writing explicitly parallel programs, and correspondingly, system support for those two styles of explicitly parallel programs. One is called message passing style of explicitly parallel program. The runtime system is going to provide a message passing library which has primitives for an application thread to do sends and receives to its peers that are executing on other nodes of the cluster. So this message passing style of explicitly parallel program is true to the physical nature of the cluster. The physical nature of the cluster is the fact that every processor has its private memory, and this memory is not shared across all the processors. So the only way a processor can communicate with another processor is by sending a message through the network that this processor can receive. This processor cannot directly reach into the memory of this processor because that is not the way the cluster is architected. So the message passing library is true to the physical nature of the cluster, that there is no physically shared memory. And lots of examples of message passing libraries that have been written to support explicit parallel programming in a cluster, they include MPI, message passing interface, MPI for short, PVM, CLF from Digital Equipment Corporation. So these are all examples of message passing libraries that have been built with the intent of allowing application programmer to write explicitly parallel programs using this message passing style. And to this day, many scientific applications running on large-scale clusters in national labs like Lawrence Livermore and Argonne National Labs and so on use this style of programming using MPI as the message passing fabric. Now, the only downside to the message passing style of programming is that it is difficult to program using this style. If you're a programmer who've written sequential programs, the transition path to writing an explicitly parallel program is easier if there is this notion of shared memory, because it is natural to think of shared data structures among different threads of an application, and that's the reason making the transition from sequential program to parallel programming using, for instance, the pthread library on an SMP is fairly intuitive and easy pathway. On the other hand, if the programmer has to think in terms of coordinating their activities on different processes by explicitly sending and receiving messages from their peers, that is calling for a fairly radical change of thinking in terms of how to structure a program.